Good evening, guys. Welcome along. It's week five, and we're up for another class of Butts and Guts. I'm Karen, and if you've joined me the first time, you will need two plates and a larger weight. Okay, if you don't have the two plates, it's fine. You can really just move through the whole workout without it. They're just there for some extra resistance and a little bit more of intensity. Okay, so we're going to keep it fairly functional. So a lot of our movement will involve lots of muscle groups to burn lots of energy and also elevate our heart rate. Okay, in the long run, we're going to get some great tone. So let's get into the workout.
Can't touch this.
Okay. So bend your elbows, feet about hip width apart. So we're going to come out and in. One, two, and three. A little bit of a shoulder workout in here too. Four more. Three. Keep the elbows bent. Okay, hold it there. Up, down, hold it, and side. Up, down, hold it, and touch side. One, and two, hold and tap. One, and two, hold and tap. Up, and down, hold and tap again. One, two, three, and four. Aha, now, three, upright row. Reach down to the ankles. One, and two, three, and drop. So a little bit of a warm-up through the lower back, into the hamstrings, and of course, we've got the shoulders working for us too. Good, keep going, up and up. Now, let's take it back to the start again. Ready? Funnel. One, two, three, and four. Keep a little softness in your legs. One, two, three, and four. Well, if you're using some resistance, you're going to be feeling it right now. Like I said, doesn't matter if you haven't got any. One more. Now, guys, lift, bend, lift, bend, and side squat. Ready? Let's elevate the knee. Lift, bend, lift, bend, side squat. Again now, lift, bend down, other side, and side. Go again now, go, up, down, bend to the side. Good. Lift, down. Woo! Warming up now, lift, bend. Lift, bend. Excellent. One, two, three, and four. Up again, guys. Lift, down, lift, down. Now one more set. Each side. Hold it there. Now pulse. Three, two, and one. Now we can use those arms again. Ready now. One, two, three, center, side raise. Lift nice and wide. Woo. So, burning a little bit more energy using resistance. I want you to focus on your knees. Make sure the knee tracks out to the second and third toe. Hopefully you're a little warmer now. All right, let's do that little knee. Come back again. Ready? One, two, three, four. Side. Now pulse. Three, two, one, and lift. Three, two. Use the knee. One, two, three, four. Bend and bend. Now pulse for three, two, and one. Center. Three, two, and one. Fantastic. Now, you may still use one of these weights or pick up something heavier. I'll grab something a little heavier. Okay. Now, hands onto the weight. Two squats to begin with. All right, guys. So we're going to add a little swing to the front. Good. So whilst we squat, we keep a nice long arm, really pushing, adding a little momentum. Okay, so this will also stimulate a little bit of core activation. So yes, whilst we work our legs, the lower body, glutes, we are using our whole body in this one. Now, this time, add a twist and then come forward. Add a twist, forward. Little one across. It's like throwing a little bit of weight across and over the body. Now, followed by these squats, we'll go into some lunges shortly. Hold it there now, three pulses, and swap. Good. Now reversing the lunge, keep your body nice and tall. Now again, a little bit of extra activation. Little twist. Good. Okay, now hold it, guys. Reverse for singles. Nice. Now, sink a little bit. Keep control of this. We don't want to drop the knee really low to the floor. Control this through the strength of your legs and glutes. Good work, guys. Now, pushing just in front. So making your body work in two directions here, up and over, and in behind. Now back to the squats and swing. Woo. Now guys, swing, and then swing slightly on the lateral. Ooh. That's it. Good to burn lots of energy here. Next winter months, heading in. I've been getting in a little bit too much cooking lately. All right. Hold it. And single lunge. Down. Down. Now this time, push upwards. Again. Up. Hopefully I won't wear your arms out too much. We need them next. Now pulse, hold it. One, two, and three. One, two, three. Better give your arms just a short break. Now, next up, now that we've got our legs and glutes really working, we're gonna do a little bit of a walking plank. Okay, so we're gonna move from side to side. So what we'll do is we'll go down into our plank position. All right, you can pop that weight down for a moment. Now we'll do a little bit of a knee in between. So we'll break it up and do that in between. But for now, we'll walk our hands in front. I'll move my towel out of the way. So we're gonna go to the left side. We go across, across, hold it, then drive the knee, hold it there. Now we're gonna go back the other way, cross, cross. Now the knee, cross we go. Good work, guys. Over, 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 over. Knee. Now back across. Now, hopefully you can feel the workload hit you. Feeling strong and athletic through the body. Good. Over we go. Now maybe we can stretch that little bit further across. Bigger hands. Bigger hands. Now one more time. Cross, cross. Cross, cross. Knee. Cross. And the knee. Hold it there, guys. Knee down. Now with this one, can you see me? Opposite. Now swap sides. Up and squeeze. Push long. Okay, guys, come back into your plank. Step across with the hands. Now the knees. Now step across, hands and legs. Hands and legs. Knees. Good. Upper, upper. Across we go again. Across we go. Knees. And four. Woo. Excellent. Well done, guys. I'm going to spread my towel out again. Now, we're going to lay down on the floor. Now, what we're going to do here. Now, think about rolling away from your body and back with this one. So let's practice and back like this, okay? So first of all, one and two, roll forward and roll back. So up with the arms, straight legs, roll front and roll back. So up and up. Keep the arms long, halfway and halfway back. Up. So trying to keep the movement nice and functional. Up. Down we go and back. Hold it, guys. Now knee on each side, just bringing it forward. Now take the hands back. very light on your feet or heels. Now take it across alternately. So we're working across our waist. You'll feel this work down into your core. So last week I did quite a focus on the legs and glutes. So I thought only fair really that I give you a little bit of extra focus this week on the core. All right, if that's okay with you. All right, can we go back to the last one? Straight legs. Up. And up. All over. And back. Roll over and back. Let's keep get a couple more in. Okay guys, let's now add a double. One and two. All right, so opposite side. And two. Keep going. In with the knee. Straighten the leg. One. And two. Well, I'm hoping now you can feel all through the core. We've definitely given these muscles a great start. Stretch long. Guys, now one more. Feet down to the floor. Now think about a circle going anti-clockwise. We're going to go round in a circle all the way. Try not to pull forward on the head. Make sure this comes right at the waist. Gosh, I can feel that. Definitely feel it. Now let's go the other way. We're on the clockwise movement. Good, now let's turn it back anti-clockwise. Just two. Now go clockwise, back around that other way. And back. Good, back clockwise. Now one of each, anti-clockwise, and clockwise. All the way around, nice big circle. Whoa. Running it out a little bit now. One more here, clockwise and around. Fantastic. All right, I want to keep you on this nice, strong core workout, really. Okay, but first, what I want you to do here is pick up your feet. All right, guys. We are starting from the lower part of the movement. With your back anchored down, we do here, in, check it out, and down. So in, out, knees and down. So
So take the knees out wide. It's fairly quick, this one. That's it. You want to bring those knees wide. Again, large muscle groups, a little bit of extra work, creating more stability training. All right. So the more movement and joint action, probably the more stimulus through the body, which we're all for, really, to keep it strong and athletic. This will also give us a little bit of preparation for some of the adductor work we'll do soon. I'm going to do some work where we use those inner thighs a little bit more. Okay, now it doesn't hurt any of us to give our bodies a little bit of extra work there, right? Sometimes when you get in there and do a little bit of specific work, you realize how much you need it. So let's focus on that next. If you're a runner, walker, you do a lot of steps, bike, it's really important to keep the balance through your quads as well. So hopefully we can create a little bit more balance as well. Protect your knees. Keeping strong. Well, don't know about you guys, but this is starting to really take a hold. Hold it there. Now, lower your hands. Bring your feet down. Now, from the bottom of the floor, just a small movement. Just a small tap. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Feet down, hands back. Reach one hand out to the side and down to the ankle. Run for cover. Now swap. Now four, one, two, three, four. Swap over. One, two, three, four. Swap five. Now two of each. And one of each, one and one. Fantastic. Okay, guys, come on up. Roll over to your side. Now, this is where you can grab that plate. So if you have some resistance, whatever it may be, okay, take one foot just in behind. We're going to place the weight just on the inner thigh. So there's a meaty little muscle in there, okay, and we want to keep that weight sitting nicely on there, okay? Now, with your leg just bent in behind, just to create a little bit of extra support, arm to the front of you. Now, we're just going to do three pulses. Now, you want your ankle to move up toward the ceiling right now, okay? So, avoid sort of swinging the toe up, okay? We want to make sure the ankle comes up. So, really pushing to get inside those quads, okay? Into the abductors. Excellent. Now this is one exercise. The next one I do will create a little bit of extra work on your obliques, so on those diagonal muscles, that deep layer of muscle to your core. Okay. So this is the first one on the adductors. Okay. So legs. Next one we involve also these muscles and the core. All right. We'll just get some singles in here. So up and down. Now I'm going to get you to pop the weight down, lay back, and place that foot just on the inner thigh. Now bringing your leg up like this. So same pattern. All right, so a little lift. Now we'll do a set of eight. but we'll involve a little bit of a lift. Okay, so elbow up to the quad or the knee. So that's 3 and 4. Alright. And 6, 7, and 8. Now, come back up, guys. Place that same weight on the same side. Alright, we'll do the same exercise. 3 pulses. 1, 2, and 3. There we go. So, who have I got tonight? Who's participating at the moment? Spoke to Deb earlier. Hear that there, Deb? Training hard there. I often do get people asking me whether I'll put some of these adductor exercises in. So, guys, I must have heard you. All right, just 2 more. And 1 more. All right, now, if you feel a little fatigued, you don't have to pop that foot on. Obviously, that makes it a little bit harder. You can put the foot behind if you want. All right, guys, elbow up. Ready, go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo. Good. Come back to the middle before we go to the other side. Now, pick up that weight once again. Up and over. Hold. Lean back. Up and over. Hold. Up and over. Hold. And again. One more. Oh, well done there, guys. Now, let's move across to the other side. Okay, plate comes into the inner thigh. Once again, pop it on. All right, so 1 and 2 and 3. That's it. Just make sure the weight sits secure where you want it to be. So you can slide around from the ankle to the ceiling. Oh, this is fun. Training together again. Well, I hope you've been pretty consistent, guys. So we're up to week 6, and you've been consistent. I do believe that when you come back to the gym, it's not going to be quite so tough. You'll be fine. You'll prove through the workouts a little bit more comfortably. And coming into the nice weather, you'll be in great shape. Oh, so again. Now singles, 8, 7, we'll go a little faster, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. One more. Oh gosh, hard work there. Okay, lie back down. Now keep this leg in behind, keep that leg straight. Stand back, support the head, lift the leg. Okay, so we just start the first 8 and 7. Come back. Now, let's bring the elbow to the quad or to the knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. 8. Woo. Okay, guys, come back up. Place that foot behind there. Now, place that weight just up there onto your inner thighs. 3, 2, and 1. There you go.
catching up with a couple of friends and having a coffee, be nice. Oh dear. Couple more. And one more time. Oh, you are on this side, slightly slower, Tom. Okay, come on back, guys. Here's your last 8 now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Woo! Excellent. That was a great effort, guys. Well done. All right, now what we're going to do is involve ourselves in a little bit more rotational movement side to side. So we're going to do some vertical lifts and some rotation. So come on back onto your back. Okay, so lifting in and forward, simple movement. So chest comes into your thighs. Keep a little bend in your knees. Okay, now moving away from the body, hold the knees bent, cross, hip, center and back, same side. Nice big kick there and roll it back. So you're using the core, the rotational movement, also through the lumbar spine too. That's a nice one too. You get that gentle little stretch as you move. Now let's go back to the middle and reverse. Now we'll go for 4 more, guys. So 1 and 2. Now this time we'll rotate the opposite side. So roll over, cross, and a little kick. And center. Keep one arm just long on the floor. Well, my arm might be a little bit out of your vision. If it is, this arm is just on the floor to support your body. Cross and kick. Back to the center. Now back to the reverse, so in and down. All right, now reach down into the ankles. Don't forget to keep your breathing flowing. Good. Okay, so that's nice invigorating across your core. Now let's roll over into elbows down to the floor, posterior position, and we're going to push up. We're going to do a little bit of glute work, and I'm going to keep the movement pattern pretty simple. All right, so we're going to come down onto the floor, elbows down. Now pick up your front leg and push. 2 and 3, bring your knee down to the floor. So pushing up now all the way. Now, strong through the core.
You want to keep your body stable without rocking or moving excessively. So just pushing, using all of your glutes. That's what we really want to feel. Your hamstrings are coming here too. Now, just two more here. Okay, hold it, guys. Now, take the hands out. Lean forward. Okay, drop the hips. And now, push up. Just to break it up so we can move between the two sides. Now, if you're feeling super strong tonight, I'm happy for you to do a little bit more. Let's get eight more. Oh, hold it there now. Elbows down. Move to the other side. Push. Two, three, and knee down. Again, elbows down. And think about your glutes. Think about that push. That's where the mechanics come from. Nice work. It's all about balance and definitely getting that posterior work into the body is excellent. Okay, now next one. Keep your legs out straight. Now it's upper body only to begin with. So we're going to push up and down, up and down. A little bit of assistance from the upper body. Just rolling those shoulder blades back very lightly. Now hold it. Hands in. lift and lift, down and down. Now we need to be very controlled about where our feet go, okay? We don't want to drop them. Now if it is a little bit much, pretty simple. We keep it at a bent knee. Okay, so if you've been suffering any kind of lower back pain, you know, definitely pick the option which is a little bit safer for you, okay? Okay, now this time keep your legs down on the floor, upper body, eight. Good, four to go. Hey. Good, hands back, now up, down, now switch sides, down and down, switch again. Lift, lift, down and switch. One more. Up and up. Keep the legs down. Up. Good. Hold it there. Now, take the legs back. Back, out, and out. So, what comes in, and again. Again, we want to keep it nice and soft. So don't plant the legs down too hard. Control it through the core. So you can also maintain a good spine. Now we lead on the opposite side. So take it back down. It does make a little bit of a difference when we swap those sides. Okay, so hopefully now you've had a little rest through your upper body. Now, take the arms down. Now this time we're going to bring the knees in and back. So lift in and back. Use those arms to push your chest a little closer. Now hold it, and crunch, crunch, and crunch. Keep going, eight, seven, six, and five, four, three, two, and one. Now, what I'm gonna do now is bring you over into a plank. If we can just lower our elbows directly under our shoulders, and you can come onto your toes. Alright, now guys, what we'll do here, up, up, down, and hold. Hold it. Now hold still, come back,
into the hold on once again. And show that you can. Now a little bit of rhythm in here. Hold stable. Knee and push the heel. One, two, push. That's it. Think you can rock those heels back away. Hold it. Now tummy down. Hands. And to a single lift. Back extension. Now let's pick up these legs. Onto your outer thigh. Lifting. Nice and straightforward this one. Okay. Now seeming we've done so much on the course, this is a great way to finish, I think, tonight. Well, it's certainly been a different household for me this week. Ollie back at school and Tom teaching and a bit quieter. Brendan had a job, so I had the whole house to myself for a while there. So now lifting, now draw the knee forward, so straight leg up and knee forward. Now a little bonus though, Jack came to visit and we had a cup of tea and a slice together, so that was nice. All right, guys, here we go. Let's get another 8 more reps. 1 and 2. 3 and 4. Now, I feel like we've had a really good balance across the whole body. I don't think there's much we left unturned, so well done for all of what you've done tonight. Okay, last one here, guys. Hold it. Now, weight down, switch over to the other side. Okay, weight to the other thigh. So lift, starting with a split lift. Try not to let that weight slip. I've got some different leggings on tonight, so good. Keep going there. Lift. Keep that toe facing me.
Don't be surprised if this side goes with a little sympathy on the other. We already know what we need to do. All right, so we're going to do a lift and a knee. Good. Upwards. In. I guess our body's our masterpiece, isn't it? Working on our body, our masterpiece. Oh, somehow our mind's never complete. Oh. Come on, we've got this. Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Well done. Pop that weight down if you were using a weight. Fabulous work, guys. Fabulous work. Okay, it's time to chill, relax, and get a nice stretch. Roll over onto your knees to begin with. Take the arms in front and drop your hips back.
She was nice in so many different ways.
Yeah, get to the center. Create an arch through your spine and center the body. Now walk your hands across to the side, take the weight off your knees and drop the hip down. Nice stretch up from the side. Into your body. Cross the other way. Now center. Take one leg in front. Now lower your chest and just use the inside elbow there to the inside of your knee. Push down. Now just climb your body back up, your toes, and a little reach there. Stretching back through the hamstrings. Good. Now to the other side. And just coming back, stretch forward to the hamstrings. Now, to come up, stand tall. Thanks, Gerard. Step behind, reach up and over. Center your body. Now, how's your balance tonight? Quadricep. Said they might come and do the butts and guts, so hopefully you got a bit of a chance to get in there and do it.
Thank you so much, guys. Week 6 done. You're doing a great job. Hang in there. See you next week. There's an angel contemplate my